Waste management is a significant issue both before, during, and after a disaster. In today's episode, I'm speaking with Akshay Gunteti out of Hyderabad, India, about a program called Green Worms Waste Management. He's the head of partnerships, and he's talking to me today about some of the work that they're doing in order to ensure that no waste goes into the landfill that doesn't need to go there, and that they can actually recycle some of the products that are there and make something even better. So stay tuned. Hey Akshay, good to see you today. I hope you're doing well. Can you just start before we get into the topic, just to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Thank you for having me here. It's very good to interact with you on this interview. So I'm a waste management professional working in a company called Green Worms, working as a head of partnerships. And personally, I like traveling and, you know, meeting like-minded people. And recently, you know, I have started writing my first book. It's called COVID-19 Leadership, and where I'll be talking about various stories on leadership during the new age crisis like COVID-19 pandemic. And apart from all this, I'm a great advocate for climate action, you know, where, you know, demonstrating the need for, you know, protecting our environment. So that's the intro about myself.
That's great. So can you tell me a little bit about Green Worms Waste Management? What is it and what do you guys try to do?
Green Worms is a social impact driven waste management company, and our major of our workforce is a woman from marginal communities. And we started in 2014, where we used to manage 300 kgs of waste per day. And we work mainly in the coastal and climate vulnerable regions, where our focus was to mitigate oceanic plastic pollution. And we work in the area of municipal solid waste management, and our focus is to work with government bodies such as municipalities and gram panchayats, and to engage the community through community building programs, as well as stakeholder engagement. So we have our own material recovery facilities where we have a huge workforce working, and here we segregate waste that been collected from the various households. We segregate, and then we manage the recyclables and non-recyclables, and we have various types of waste we process. So far we are managing 60 tons of waste per day, and we created over 160 plus dignified jobs for local women. And so far it's all bootstrapped. We are self-funded, and I'm really proud of the journey that's been done so far, and completely satisfied with the work we have done on the ground.
So what are some of the biggest challenges that you see?
The challenges in the waste management sector in Indian context, there are a few aspects. The first one, the understanding the importance. There has been a lot of waste crisis that India has been facing, and there is very least importance or the priority given to the waste management sector. It's an essential service, and it has to be given a significant importance in the ecosystem. Secondly, it's not about how much quantity of waste we manage or create. We need to focus on something turning into a waste, the last thing, and we need to minimize our waste generation. And the third, the working in the waste management sector, people think it's a dirty job, and it's a duty of a rag picker or someone else, but this sector has a very direct impact on the environment. If you do work in the waste management sector, you are literally saving our planet. You are literally saving our planet. And A few is the COVID situation. You know, due to the COVID, the safety of our waste workers are at a threat. And because there is no proper action towards segregation of waste in terms of biomedical waste, such as gloves, masks, and all, you know, even sanitizers. So, which has more vulnerable to the waste workers? And the other is the recycling infrastructure is not yet developed in India. It's very at a nascent stage. So, it would take some time to have a collaborative ecosystem. And the 80% of the waste in India is accountable for the government, such as municipalities. And this was completely operated by the government. So, in order to develop or in order to do some significant impact, we need to give access to the private players who can work on ground and deploy various, you know, sustainable practices to implement a sustainable waste management. So these are the few challenges. You know, I hope these challenges would have different challenges would be there in different sectors. But so far, we are taking up these challenges, trying to, you know, overcome the roadblocks. And, you know, during these uncertain times, like, you know, COVID-19 lockdown and safety of our waste workers, with resilience, we've been tackling this and we've been so good at making things possible. So I'm optimistic. Again, you know, we started with 300 kgs to going 60 tons of waste per day, and from one job to 160 dignified jobs. So all we need to do is be optimistic and believe in what we are doing, try to work and help others, and let we mainstream the waste management sector in India, and which eventually will protect our environment as well as the safety of our communities.
What are some of the biggest opportunities you see?
Regarding to opportunities, I think there are a lot of opportunities in the waste management sector, especially there are a lot of innovation that's been happening from automation, you know, AI, machine learning, and also, you know, how to convert waste into energy, waste into fuel, you know, waste into, you know, upcycling, and, you know, various new products that can come out of the waste. So one thing we need to look at is how we can convert this waste into something very useful, you know, rather than you know, going into the landfills. You know, that only should enable the circular economy. I think that's where you know, the opportunities lies in the waste management sector. And also, like, you know, this all, there is a lot of you know, PPEs which are, you know, made out of plastic and all. So, you know, this lead to a larger crisis, but at the same time, there's a scope for us to take this crisis to act, and, you know, to deploy resources to do research on how we can mitigate plastic pollution as well as a waste management crisis at a larger picture.
Is there anything else you want to comment on before we wrap up?
So finally, you know, I would like to conclude this current crisis, you know, the COVID-19 pandemic. We have never seen this before, and this is the time we need to understand the importance of the environment and the need for the waste management, and how we can prepare for the future so that we can able to tackle this and also prevent such crisis. So let's all be resilient, let's innovate, let's emphasize the current situations and thrive forward. So thank you so much, Lane, for giving me opportunity, and I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you.
Well, thanks again, Akshay. Appreciate all of the insights that you've given us and the work that you're doing. Wishing you all the best.